the sanctified life, tobacco. James says that the wisdom which is from above is first pure. James 3 verse 17. If he had seen his brethren using tobacco, would he not have denounced the practice as earthly, sensual, devilish? Verse 15. In this age of Christian light, how often the lips that take the precious name of Christ are defiled by tobacco spittle, and the breath is polluted with the stench. Surely the soul that can enjoy such uncleanness must also be defiled. As I have seen men who claim to enjoy the blessing of entire sanctification while they were slaves to tobacco, polluting everything around them, I have thought, how would heaven appear with tobacco users in it? God's word has plainly declared that there shall in no wise enter into it anything that defileth. Revelation 21 verse 27. How then can those who indulge this filthy habit hope to find admittance there? Men professing godliness offer their bodies upon Satan's altar and burn the incense of tobacco to his satanic majesty. Does this statement seem severe? Certainly, the offering is presented to some deity. As God is pure and holy and will accept nothing defiling in its character, he must refuse this expensive, filthy, and unholy sacrifice. Therefore, we conclude that Satan is the one who claims the honor. Jesus died to rescue men from the grasp of Satan. He came to set us free by the blood of his atoning sacrifice. The man who has become the property of Jesus Christ and whose body is the temple of the Holy Ghost will not be enslaved by the pernicious habit of tobacco using. His powers belong to Christ, who has bought him with the price of blood. His property is the Lord's. How then can he be guiltless in expending every day the Lord's entrusted capital to gratify an appetite which has no foundation in nature? An enormous sum is yearly squandered for this indulgence while souls are perishing for the word of life. Professed Christians rob God in tithe and offerings while they offer on the altar of destroying lust in the use of tobacco more than they give to relieve the poor or to supply the wants of God's cause. Those who are truly sanctified will overcome every hurtful lust. Then all these channels of needless expense will be turned to the Lord's treasury, and Christians will take the lead in self-denial, in self-sacrifice, and in temperance. Then they will be the light of the world. The Sanctified Life, Chapter 3, Controlling the Appetites and Passions.